All right, so now you have those travel rewards, it's time to travel. Joining me, travel journalist Patricia Schultz with her top trips and tips for women travelers and what all women should know before they hit the road.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Thanks for being here. There's a Travel Industry Association survey that found that an estimated 32 million single American women traveled at least once in the last year. What did the survey reveal about why and how women travel?
Well, certainly none of it came as a surprise to me because I've been doing it since forever. But the guided vacation company Trafalgar, who has been doing this for decades and is as passionate about travel as I am, they've understood early on what we all have, which is that travel is easy for us, really, as Americans with passports and able to get visas, that travel is inspiring, it's an education, it opens up your head and your eyes, it really, you know that old expression, how it widens your horizons? Well, it truly does in every sense of the word. So women are traveling independently solo, they're traveling independently but with guided groups or vacations, and they're traveling more often and farther afield. You know, gone are the days when you would just take a bus into the closest large town, but they're getting on planes, they're traveling to the other side of the globe, and they're traveling, I think, with a greater understanding that the independence that travel promises, the sense of how it emboldens us, it empowers us, it makes us more courageous and brave, and all of these things that you learn in life, life lessons that you bring with you into the future.
Tell us about some of the new unique travel experiences.
I think the very fact that women are striking off and on their own, you know, whether you go with a group, there are so many companies now that will waive single supplements. There are cruise ships that are incorporating more single cabins. There are companies that provide specialized thematic departures, if you know food or writing or art is your thing, if Italy is your destination, they're acknowledging that there are more women traveling, and the possibilities and the offerings I think reflect that. There are many places here in our backyard. It doesn't need to be extravagant and expensive, and so many, not just women, Americans don't even hold passports. It's something that has always astonished me. But there are so many possibilities here in our backyard, just in the States, whether you're visiting national parks for all of the natural beauty we have, or for the music festivals, or ideally to go overseas, because I like to encourage women especially to kind of mix it up.
Well, being a woman myself, I've got to ask you, what are your top five tips for women travelers?
I think number one is to acknowledge that that fear is not a bad thing. You know, embrace the fear. I've always just seen it as excitement or even an exhilaration. So if you're fearful, you know, I always am. You know, you're leaving everything that's comfortable. You're leaving everybody who speaks English. You're leaving your little comfort zone. So, you know, forget the comfort zone. Not much happens there. And get out the front door. I think you should do your homework ahead of time to just wing it, and you know, depend upon serendipity, and flexibility is also a wonderful thing. But I always have, for example, my hotel booked in advance. I like to know that I'm going to have a place to park my suitcase at the end of it all. Understand a little bit about the destination. I do an awful lot of research online, and I actually read books. But there's so much to have just on the internet as well. It can be a little bit overwhelming. But understand what the neighborhoods are that might be a little dicey that you want to avoid, and know what the attractions are. I mean, you may only have a limited amount of time. Do you want to leave town without having seen all of the good stuff? So be prepared. And then, like I said, leave a certain degree of flexibility for serendipity, because they say that serendipity is the best tour guide.
And how is travel being celebrated during the month of March?
Well, there, I think, will be a lot of emphasis put on, in the world of travel, certainly the early adventurers, the women who stood out, those who blazed the trail for us, those who make it possible today for women to be seen not as the oddball solo, you know, adventurers who are only one of a kind. You're seeing them in larger numbers. You're seeing them in, you know, remote, far-flung areas around the world. Trafalgar is offering a She Goes campaign that are offering different destinations that reflect the reasons that women travel, to escape routine, to celebrate, to learn something new and exciting.
Wonderful. Where can people go for more travel information?
To the website trafalgar.com. Everything you need to know.
Thanks so much for joining me, Patricia. Happy travels.
Thank you. Thank you very much. You too, Audrey.